So I'm again at Elnestangen. I have been there a couple of weeks ago, and when I was looking out of the window, I saw all this mist and fog developing over the forest and the fjord, and it's very nice. So last time I showed you that pyramid-shaped mountain, which is called Jandamsfjell. This time I might take pictures of it, maybe not, but I try to find some nice atmospheric compositions with that mist, and I hope it will stay, will not leave. But from what I have seen when I was driving down here, that in the mountains there is hanging the fog. I really hope that the mist will be still there when I found a good place to take pictures of. Yeah, so what I did now was I took multiple pictures of the same frame, absolutely the same. I took one picture without any filter, just that picture. And the sky was overexposed, of course. The sunlight is quite high now. The next picture I took was with a neutral density grad filter. So to make the sky darker. And what also happened, because I was shooting more or less directly into the sunlight, you had some lens flares in the picture. And the last thing I did was, the last picture I took was to put a hand in front of the sunlight so that the lens flares would disappear. So what I will do eventually is probably only taking two pictures, the one with where I use the ND filter and the one where I put the hand in front of the sun. And those one I will blend together, the one with ND filter for the sky and the one where I put the hand on for the foreground. I want to try to take another picture from Jandamsfjell. The issue or the challenge which I have here is you have the shoreline, then you have a lot of water, and then you have that mountain in the background and other mountains and some islands far away. So basically you can take a picture of Jandamsfjell, which you see here in the background, of course. The challenge which I have now here is I have the shoreline here, which is great, absolute good to have, but and then you have at the horizon that that mountain, and in between you have a lot of water and nothing is happening there. And this needs to be filled in some way. So since there is nothing, as you can see, I have to find another solution, and there's something very simple to do, and this will definitely improve your landscape picture for sure. If you understand that principle, just let me show you what I want to do. So if I though the camera is now on my basically on my eyesight, so 160, 170 centimeters or so over ground. What I will do now is I will go low with the camera towards the ground. Look at that. As you can see, the empty space becomes less. Let me show you. I can go even more down. 1 second. Like that. And the negative space is not so negative anymore. So I was walking now quite a bit, and I definitely will return. I'm now standing here at the shore. Sunset will be very soon, in about 1 hour or so. Maybe I will get some nice colors in the clouds, like the sun reflecting those nice beautiful red colors. But we will find out. I will go back now, and hopefully I will be successful. If the sunrise will not be good, I will probably not take any more pictures. That would be the end of the video then. I just came back to that place where I was before. I guess I have to wait now 1 hour. But here's the bench, so everything is fine. Yeah, so it looks promising. It is very possible that I will be able to take some nice pictures of the sunset. Yeah, and get some nice mood, some nice red atmosphere, glow, or what you wanna call it. And we will see. Now it's officially sunset. It's like 10:11 past 4, and this is the exact time for the sunset. But it is getting dark and gray, and I'm pretty sure there will not come any red glow anymore today. I will go back now towards the parking place. But so now it's low tide. When I came here was high tide, and I will try to go as much beside the shore as possible, and if I find something that looks interesting to take pictures of, I will definitely do. I might have found a composition here. Let me show you. See, there is this water hole, and there you have that mountain. And that I want to use like as a foreground, as a focal point. And then you also have those rocks here. Might look good. If you like that video, then I want to ask you to give it a thumb up, and consider to subscribe if you want to see more what I do, because I will definitely make more videos like that, and I try to improve each time. I'm a new YouTuber, I have not even 20 videos on my channel. Yeah, and if you want to see how I as a filmmaker develop, and if you like my pictures and my style, then I want to ask you to subscribe. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you a very nice day.